Very good morning. Scaling tough times. Before we go into the topic, let us understand the very meaning of this. Grappled with its connotations and the way it affects all of us. On reflecting upon that, you will understand that you cannot get away with any of the challenges or difficulties in life. You see, these tough times, they come and go. Pandemic came and pandemic went away, or it's going. So when pandemic comes, when tough times come, when difficult times come, when challenges come, changes are bound to happen. So changes become inevitable. But while the pandemic is going away, the difficult situation is going away, we have no mind to move away from the very situation. It leaves us engrossed. We like battling with a lot of issues. Originally, we would not have planned at all that our life would end up like this. So our human mind is unwilling to push you forward. So how can we blame a tough time? How can we tell that it is a tough time? How can we tell pandemic is a tough time when my mind is posing all the problems? I don't want to move away. I feel happy battling with it. And I don't want to let it go. I want to see, I know each problem, each challenge is so different and distinct. But still, I want to just stay in the same place. So this is exactly what is happening in a human mind. I just want you to take a chance to read Dr. Robert's Color. The me I see is the me I will be. This is the concept that he's talking. The title of the book is Tough Times Never Last. But who will last is the tough people. So as faculty members, it is time for becoming tough. It is time to prove that you are already tough. So only tough people are going to last, because you will become what you really perceive. So your perception must be so clear. This is exactly what you have to do. One more thing is, only in such a darkest hours, you will rediscover your true strength, your innate strength and the light. You will do that inner engineering to bring that brilliant light within yourself. That will never go dim. So this you have to keep in mind and understand it. And I sit here to talk to a batch of people, a group of powerful people. You are power-packed faculty members. This is time that you have to apply all characteristics of resolute individuals. You have to check on your belief system. When we say we believe ourselves, what do we mean by that? We mean that we have an extra capacity. We have a spontaneous ability to push ourselves first to change. And we think that our perception must be very clear. So we have that clarity of perception and we build our courage to model values, to stand in front of others. As an example, every single period, every single day, every single moment you are going to do that, then people are going to think that you have a virtue. I look up to a role model. I don't look up to a teacher who is going to teach a unit in electronics. I look up to a teacher who is talking about the values over that lesson. This resilience is a built-in virtue. It should have been there in your school days only. And even in your earlier childhood. Having said that, if they do not come and sit in front of you with resilience, what is your duty? You exercise your faculty power and make resilient individuals. That is the need of the hour. This is possible only when they have that innate qualities to read widely, to have reflective thinking, to go to people at times of contingencies, and to participate with the leadership skills. They will not come to you. Children, students will not come to you. Students fresh from class 12, they come to you. In school, maybe they have a hand-holding system until class 8 or until class 6. Then we do not even know whether their goals are set, whether they are, you know, they are clear about the path, whether they really want to do what they really want to become and how they have to go towards that, they may not know. So now it is the time to understand them, for studying them. If you do not have resilience, you won't be able to read your students at all. This is going to happen. This is what is going to happen. So resilience is a built-in virtue. We are going to tell them that this is coming out of a fact that you keep your mind clear. You zero down everything inside your head. So you just have to make them understand that you have to make a decision that I will build this. And then the next quality that he has to take is that he has to get accustomed. He has to become adaptable. So he adapts things which are, you know, necessary. What is really correct? What is the choice that he is going to make? He will face, as a student or as a faculty member, you will face issues of all ranges. And why do we have such ranges? We are not prepared to keep men separate and matter separate. So we go behind some standard approaches which are already there. We have some steadfast speed and we like following such approaches, and we want to please individuals and we want to have, you know, the adherence to these processes. We are focusing on that, not focusing on the change that you might make. If required, you must revisit. You have a strong dislike to revisit, to change. And you cannot do that with the partiality. You must be impartial. So if you have a strong dislike to revisit and be impartial, then you are not adaptable. So this you have to understand. Basically, you understand all these things, then you know that you have to keep your mind very clear. So when your mind is clear, when you are ready to make a choice, okay, let me build resilience and adaptability. Who is going to then, what next? Then I have to work on my presence of mind. My presence of mind is good. Somebody was asking me a question. So how we are emotionally affected when some problem comes, how do we get out of that? And how do we get out of that situation? See, you have to train. These are all trainable attitudes and qualities. So you have to improve your presence of mind, and it has to go in jet speed, and you must have the readiness. When will you get the readiness? You must learn to have, you know, you must be well informed. You must know, you must have that clarity of perception. And most importantly, you must know the purpose behind this. So if you know that, then you will be so ready to do what is necessary. And there will be a fighter blooming up from within. And that fighter will fight only with the self. You will fight with your own self. Instead of we are fighting with our neighbors, we are fighting with our, you know, we are fighting with, an, you know, the colleagues. We are fighting with some other institution. We are fighting with results. So we are not keeping ourselves clear. Our ideas are not clear. That is why we are telling you, if you are coming out with an idea that I am a very positive person, you have to rethink. Go and think for half an hour. Then only you will know. And one fine morning you will realize, oh, positivity, have I not understood it properly? For most of the people today, I tell you, just remains an illusion. So they have a wrong pitch initially, and then everything else they do correctly, they are going to fail. They are going to miserably fail. So understanding of the first point is that you have to keep your head clean. This must be clean. So that is going to decide. That is a choice you have to make. Then if that is clean, then you will be ready to give any space to the best thing that is necessary for you. If you are able to identify that particular source which can take you to a land of possibilities, then your possibilities are limitless. Then if you take the correct step, it will define how far you have articulated positivity so far. You have understood, you have articulated, and that which is coming from within, not by looking at someone, not by comparing with someone, not by having some graphs in front of you. It has to come from within. So this evolution is happening minute by minute, second after second. And this only will tell you how far you can go. So now that being said, now you will know that you have to settle. Your mind is clear. You are prepared to learn. You are prepared to change. And you are prepared to model. And you are prepared to wait and take n number of chances to improve yourself. Then reality comes. Now you are settling yourself to face reality. Now understand the reality. Fear will come and occupy your mind. Doubt will come and occupy your mind. Ego will be there throughout your body. Betrayal, you will be worried about what is not at all applying to your life. And you will be looking at your opinionated world. And this is just a baggage. It doesn't even exist in reality only. So now you got to shoo that away. Why? Who is responsible for this? I will tell you. So you have to set your mind against fear, doubt, ego, betrayal. This world, when it is opinionated, world is a beautiful matter. World is the world has beautiful people. We have to identify ourselves. The most, magnificent person that you have seen in this world is only you. You try to do an inner engineering and then come out. Keep the world away. When it is having an opinion which you do not agree, you don't have to agree any opinion that others are telling. So this baggage, I tell you, it is not even existing. That is reality. Accept this reality. So fear is not going to get me a better mark sheet. Fear is not going to get a very good name from my vice chancellor. Fear is not going to give me awards and rewards. So let me set my mind one thing clear. Then let me have the ability to keep myself, accept reality. So now I really want to take you to Osho. This Osho, somebody was going and asking him, how will we survive this pandemic of cholera? So he says, don't come and ask me all these questions. People are going to die. But you are telling me they are dying out of disease. No, they are not dying out of disease. They are dying out of the fear that is there as it has taken roots in their mind. What do you mean by that? This fearful environment is there around us. Will it go away? It will go away. It will go away when? It will go and come back. Now pandemic will go and one flood will come up. Then that will go. Then unemployment will come out. Problems will be there. You prepare yourself so well and go to class. Examinations are fast approaching. Attendance will be very poor. He will have his own agenda. So this fear, if you are allowing fear to be a dominant factor in your life, if you do not know how to attack it and destroy it, I quote Chanakya, the strategic, the most political, the best writer of 375 to 250 BC. As soon as fear approaches near, attack and destroy it. In case you are attacking, you are not destroying. Fear will be persistent, it will come back again, like Osho said. So you have to be very clear. So how to control this fear? There is something called a small voice inside you. It is there in your brain. That is only hampering your spirit to identify your vision. Each child, each student, each individual is born with a vision. Who has to find that vision? He himself will have to find the vision. Who can help him? A teacher can help him. A teacher can help him, empower, the teacher can empower himself and get risen to, you know, he can go up till the level of a guru, that the child will lay trust on the, you know, on the faculty or the teacher. A teacher once is a teacher forever. So this small voice can be controlled if the student is having trust to listen to you. He must have the capacity to listen. The first thing that you write in your lesson plan is L, listening. If I don't listen, if I'm not taught how to listen, if I'm not trained how to listen, that small voice will take control over me and it will destroy me, as Chanakya said. It will destroy me. So you do not allow the small voice inside to take over the total control. If you allow that, you will feel as if you are caught between the devil and the deep sea. You will feel so insecure and you will not be able to move on. You will be caught between lack of understanding and lack of courage. This is a very important thing that you have to fight. It is not even fear. Lack of understanding and lack of courage. These two things, fear will take over. That small voice will help. If you don't know how to shoo the small voice, it is going to be difficult for you. I'm telling you. So now that you have come out of that, your mind will be so relieved and you will find that propelling moment. When you are able to find that propelling moment, that is the moment of change that you want to, you know, see in your life. You cannot, that moment alone will take you, that is the source, that will take you limitless power. That is so powerful that it will take you to a land of possibilities. And when you are going there, when your mind is clear, you are setting, speed is set, presence of mind is set, speed, you are going to just be that, you know, strong force where you will be helping your students to stay consistent. When will they become consistent? They have to read a lot. There will be a lot of there should be lots of activities. And you should hire all their minds. You should keep them in front of you. All the time you talk about your curriculum. This is not going to happen, my dear friend. I am telling you, consistency is missing. So they are not resilient. They are quoting fear as one source. They are having doubts. They want to speak out their fear and doubt. So they are convinced. They are convinced they can quote this. And they are so much convinced, they want to defend it. Even when they are defending it, they think that it's okay to be like that. No, that's wrong. Then humongous resilience, like how we saw Usain Bolt. 2004, he got the, you know, he got shackled. 2008, he was able to come over. What did he do? He did not try to win over the people who were running along with him. He won over the clock that was set in front of him. The finishing line, world record, world record. This is resilience. Only one vision, one point vision. One more example. We will have this Arjuna just listening. He had listening and he followed with that one point focus. Himalayan focus we had. This is the range with which you have to do. See, feel proud. We are not apes, we are human beings. See, you see animals, beautiful, you know, things on the planet, but they cannot write. They cannot investigate. They cannot go in quest. Human beings, we splice genes, split atoms, launch rockets. We peer forward or delve deeply into the digits of the pie. Perhaps most remarkably of all, we gaze inward, we try to piece all the puzzles together, and in our own unique way, and you know, bring the marvels of the brain outside. There cannot be a greater mystery than this. I'm taking this quote from the book Insight, written by Tasha. I like Emily Dickinson so much. So what I want to quote from the very Emily Dickinson, the whole world admires her for, you know, the way she writes. So she says, "You are living, man. What joy more you want? What is that? So now come to that. You're a human being. Now work on the quality of your living." I quote Emily Dickinson, "The mere sense of living is joy enough." So now what you have to do, you have to improve your quality. Your life should be enriched, so enriched. You have to keep on knowing more and enhancing your horizons of awareness. Nothing else is needed. That's what she says. So why are we even waiting? Will we really care to transform the world, to change the world? Without a wait, let us resolve to go all in and all time and stay positive. With who? The friends, family, colleagues, neighbors, immediate neighborhood, you know, and community. To share, you share more smiles, laughter, encourage everybody, and then bring that joy. See the joy on their face. Then you will know that you made the right choice to learn and to let others learn, to know and to share what you have known. So that point in time, you will know that you will have to choose optimism over pessimism, and you have to choose faith over fear. Very casually, you'll be able to take over take kindness over hate, and you'll become better instead of being bitter. And many challenges are coming. You will learn from the challenges. You will take that as a platform and learn from the challenges. Even at during adversity, you will have one point vision of staying strong together, and you will build resilience. Whatever setback you have, we had a setback in the morning, we become resilient, we solve it, and then let it go and go move on. We are not moving on, that's our issue. So, and we are allowing fear to creep in at that time, and we are not consistent. Why we have to be consistent? We have to prove ourselves to be worthy. We are different from apes, right? We are different from the other beings that are on this planet. We can think, we are alive, we can enjoy, we can smile. What is the problem in sharing? So what more do you want? You know, the only thing that you have to do is you have to step up. Success or failure, it is all the same for you. So that's what Viktor Frankl says. The choice that you make is so important that it is going to decide your growth and freedom. Between that stimulus and response, there is a space, and the space is so narrow. That is why the presence of mind, it has to go with jet speed. And in that space is our power to choose our response. And depending upon our response, there lies the growth and freedom. So time now, and time enough to do what is necessary, whatever it takes. So when you are preparing a student community, think, you go and meet them with respect, you know. So the importance of making the choice comes here. So Viktor Frankl says, between stimulus and response, there is only a very small space. And that space itself is power. Why we are telling you have to be super smart? you know, the faculty power must go all in at all time, because we need speed, because the space is minimal and the choice that we have to make is perfect, almost perfect. We can't be perfect, we can be almost perfect. When we have to choose that, then we make that choice to make a response. Why do we say this? Because that response is going to decide our growth and freedom. So this you have to keep in mind and go into the world of the student. Why we are choosing faculty, faculty power? Because that is the only, you know, requirement from the leader's side, from the management side. They have belief in you. You are going to, your students are going to listen to you, not the textbook. They are going to listen to you. Are you exercising your power? We do not know. If you do what is necessary, whatever it takes, then you will have the courage to account, stay accountable, and you will stand as a model to the student community, and they will stand accountable too. And you will accept failure. You will find out methods to become resilient, and you will show respect to your failures, and you will take that immediate effort, like how we have taken now. Something went wrong with Zoom, immediately we are making it up now. The same way we will show respect to our failures, and we'll take that effort to move forward. We will push ourselves so that we stand as an example, you know, to stand courageous. So this is very important. With a student, students in front of you, you have to check on the purity of the environment, and you have to bring them to the level. You cannot bring the student population in one level. You must have three things inside your mind. That is when we are telling that you have to get in with a warm-up activity and a few questions here and there, so that you will have to keep them alive to your voice, the concept, the language that you use, the modulations, the highs and the lows that you use. All these are very, very important. Sometimes even the way you present yourself is so good. So effort alone will not come. Courage must be there, resilience must be there, effort must be there. You have to keep on checking the purity of the atmosphere, and you have to nourish the soul, not the head. You have to nourish the soul. Then you have to have a format for doing that. This teacher will do this. This faculty will do this. This, for this doubt, I have to go here. So that procedure, that standard operating procedure, is a totally different platform. I think one other session has to be given for that. So each teacher is so unique. Each faculty member is so unique. Each human being is so distinct and different. So if we put all these things together with the good values, we are taking only three values again. We are taking resilience, adaptability, and we are taking the power within ourselves and merging it with the person who is seated in front of us. For that, we are formulating a standard operating procedure. When we do that, I'm very sure that you will teach them how to be when they do things. So they have to concentrate on living, on the being than the doing. Doing alone is not okay. Being is very much okay. So when they are who they are, then there is a sense of fulfillment. As faculty members, you will have rewarding experience. It's a messy work. It's a difficult work. But you should not give in. That is why you have to have this no-quit attitude inside your head. If it's not there, first you have to take it. First fear out. Then you have to be a fighter. Who will you fight with? You will have to fight with yourself. Then sense of accomplishment. That is the only work you have. Every single day, you have to be yourself. That is the accomplishment you have to make. So then you will get this experiential joy. And that is where you stand as a finer human being. Then you become the teacher. A teacher with the finest qualities, role model attitude, and with you know this is time for you to become that faculty member. In your life you would have come across some 60 or 70 teachers, but you remember only two teachers or three teachers in your life. You can be one among these three teachers to change a student life. They will go to heights when the teacher believes so. If you are asking the child to believe them, it will not happen. So you are going into your classroom with the dreams of your children in your mind. If you are having dream for yourself, maybe that is not good enough. So you have to be yourself. You have to take that role. You got to play that role and still be yourself. The value, as Banu has one value, that is more important than, you know, what my qualifications speak. So that is where I am going to stand different. For that value, tough time or no tough time, it is all the same. I remain the same person. Current went off, I will record it and send it. It's not there, I will write the essay and send it. So changes I am making here, not outside. Do I have here? Why? Why am I giving answer to anybody? I don't have to be afraid of the world at all. So I know that it is a challenging job. But challenges will go away. Let the challenges go. You are holding on to it. You be yourself. And you are so capable. And you have beautiful smile. You have to spread all those smiles. You have to mingle with people. You have to share. You have to constantly ask your children to read. You have to, they have to have that ceaseless quest in them. You have to give them small projects. You have to congratulate them. You have to be with them. You have to be after them. You have to just be ready to give that. You must look so learned. You must treat them like learned people. Then it is going to work out, and the greatest accomplishments will bring more great, you know, more accomplishments, not only to yourself, but to your community, especially to a wonderful university like Satya Bhama University. It was such a, you know, beautiful moment for me to talk. So today we are talking about this faculty power, a faculty power which decides, which makes a choice that students matter more. And a faculty team or a faculty development program where they will set all their mind to go all in and all time. What will they do? They will enable, they will empower, they will energize. They will enable themselves to be strong, to be able, to be that much able to push themselves and the others, so that that ability alone will have the ability to transform. I have to change and to prove myself. I have to be an example. I have to be a role model there. I have to, the faculty that I see here should know how to empower themselves with core values, the values that you exhibit, your day-to-day values that you are going to exhibit will decide who is going to listen to you and how they are going to listen to you. And energy, 8 o'clock or 5 o'clock, same energy, same love of work and going behind that purpose. Think about Arjuna and Usain Bolt. So we are all playing a game of constant change. Pandemic today comes, tomorrow something else is going to come. Constant change. We are playing a game of constant change. Don't sit in one place and think that everything is going to be served in your plate. It is not about you. You are going to be seen in your student. If student community is not okay, then we have to make changes within ourselves. That is why the faculty development program. So energize. Please help your children understand. There is a purpose in which whatever they do, and they have to go behind learning constantly without stop. You know, unstoppable learning has to happen. They have to have it as a culture, as a habit. So they have to team up. They have to make a team, and they have to create leaders also. That means they will have a choice to live as an example to the others also. I have not even one doubt that you require such a sessions, you know, to change. You are already fine individuals. I only think that with my little more experience, I will be able to see you as finer individuals now. One life. We have to make a right choice. Time is running out. It's a great privilege to be a teacher and to belong to a teaching community and to improve the horizons of learning inside us, to share, to take a platform to share, which will get you joy. So when I present this with immense joy. Whatever I do, I present it with immense love, great love. So that will not get you a failure. God bless you and stay safe. Thank you, Satyabha.